guys, welcome back to my channel. Today it's a kitchen vocabulary video. But before we start with the vocabulary words, first I want to tell you some kitchen rules. First rule is, always get your hair tied up. Second, always wear an apron. This is a plastic Doraemon apron. Well, I usually don't go too close to the fire. Well, plastic catches fire, so never go with plastic apron or any synthetic clothes near fire. But you can like wear it for washing utensils. And then always wear gloves while cutting. So now we can start with our vocabulary. So first word is a recipe. What is a recipe? Well, it is the steps followed to make something. For example, to make a chocolate muffin, we need sugar, some chocolate syrup or chocolate powder, and then the steps, what do we have to mix, and all that is a recipe. Then, ingredients. Any food item can be an ingredient. For example, a bell pepper, carrots. Then comes seasoning. Well, it can be like salt, pepper, coriander powder, anything which is in bits is a seasoning. So then, taste. The taste is how the food feels in our mouth. Bitter, sour, anything like that. And then, a chef. A chef, also known as a cook, is the person who cooks food. Cook is a noun and a verb. Well, if I want to be a cook, I'll have to wear a chef hat. And then I'm ready to be a cook. Now, for the other ones, here is a grater. Grater simply means to grate. And then this is a colander. You can use it to rinse things. Over here, just wash it. And then, from these holes, the water drains out and the food item remains in the colander. And then, here is some cutlery. Spatula, forks, spoons, knives, whisks, the cutting board to complement the knife is all cutlery. Next vocabulary word is cut. And in cut, there's slice and chop. So, chop means to do it into bits. You can chop the food item into small pieces on the chopping board. Or you can slice it. In a slice, one side is flat and it has some height on the board. Like a slice of bread, a slice of cheese. Next is peel. It is a noun and a verb. Peel. The best example to use for peel is a banana, but I don't have a banana right now. But you can peel the skin of the banana. And noun is the skin itself, the peel of the banana. And then there are some types of cooking we do, like fry, stir fry, grill, simmer. So I'm going to explain each one of them. First one is fry. Fry means, so we can put the oil, heat up the oil and then fry anything in it. So that's called fry. Stir fry needs a vessel, a spatula also. So you know, you already know fry. Stir fry means after you put the batter in the oil, you stir it. Stir means to move the spatula in a circular motion. So you stir it. And related to fry, there's also deep fry. So the vessel used for deep frying is called a deep fryer. So you can put the whole thing in it till it becomes fried. So then simmer. Simmer is when the water water becomes bubbly, but not that bubbly. You know, it starts shaking a bit, but it's not that bubbly. Boil, it is when the water is really hot and there are lots of bubbles in it. Then is grill. There are grill pans also, and at a camp you can grill sausages and all. Or in modern ovens there's grill option. So most of us have kitchen appliances at home. Some of us forget appliances, so you can just get reminded in this video. And some of the kitchen appliances are coffee maker, fridge, microwave, or microwave oven, etc. And then, while cooking, you need something to cook that food item in. So that is called a utensil. So that utensil can be a cooker or a pot. Pot is usually like bigger on the walls, and it's for more complex food or for liquids like a soup. Then pan is like not that big, it's flat.